Hello, fellow dog lovers. My name is Fawad Sadeghi, and I am the Southwest Regional Manager of Origin. I'm going to go ahead and have my team members introduce themselves.
I'm Yvonne Geyer, the Event Coordinator.
I'm Prithvi Prasad, the Marketing Analyst.
I'm Asa Sayed, the Financial Advisor.
And our project name is Taking Me Home. It is mind-boggling that over 880 dogs are euthanized in Dallas alone on a monthly basis. Only one out of every 10 dogs born will find a permanent home. Homeless dogs outnumber homeless people 5-1. Traditional dog pounds put dogs out after 2 weeks if not attended to or taken to a home. We are the voice for these voiceless animals.
We, Origin, are a Canadian biologically appropriate dog and cat food company. We produce the cat food in a way that is healthy and abundant for the dogs. We never outsource our ingredients. Everything that we gather or hunt is all regionally, found regionally. And we have a variety of different meats, such as wild turkey, we have free-range chicken, we have wild bison, and a lot of other meats. We balance our foods with whole foods, as well as vegetables and other botanicals. We're partnering with the Connie Roaster Rescue because Jay Gerrier, we believe, is a man with a very strong foundation. He's got strong convictions about his dogs, and he'd love to get everybody a new home. Jay Gerrier is the owner of Connie Roaster Rescue, as well as the Connie Roaster Restaurant and the Jolie's New York Pizza Tavern. He formed this rescue in March 2014 as a nonprofit organization, and we really want to help him establish a new shelter for his dogs so that they can all have a second chance at a new home.
Okay, so basically, in order to reach our long-term goal, we're going to have to utilize our marketing tools to the best of our abilities, because none of this is going to be possible without help from multiple organizations and donations from across the board. So we plan to raise awareness by having a fundraiser event at White Rock Lake Dog Park, and this is going to be basically to bring out people from Dallas locals who are dog lovers, current dog owners, people who are looking to adopt, and regular customers of Origin, the dog products themselves, and regular customers of the Carne Rosa restaurants, because those customers are people that are familiar with the business ethics of both companies, which is really an ethical approach across the board, from the organic foods to the Rescue Foundation and things like that. So there's going to be multiple ways we plan on bringing out awareness to the fundraiser event itself. Which is going to be utilizing social media. So number one in social media is Instagram and Twitter, because if any of you guys have a dog, I'm sure that you've probably posted a picture of your dog before, and basically what we are implementing is a hashtag photo competition, and that's going to bring awareness to the event itself, because the hashtag is actually going to say, take me home, and as you can see here, there's the two Instagram accounts, and you can see there's lots of pictures posted. So people who have heard about the account, basically what happens is they're gonna post a picture of their dog with the hashtag, and that's gonna bring awareness out to their followers about the event, and the winning prize will be that whoever, the winner will be chosen at random as the event itself, and that winner will get to be featured on the Origin website. So that's gonna be really great, because we feel like that's gonna bring out awareness to Dallas locals. And another thing is gonna be Facebook. Facebook is really helpful in terms of, we are going to post an event from the Origin website, and that's going to allow us to actually invite people, so people will be able to see the specifics and details on where it is, what it's for, and what's really going to be there. What we're hoping to get out of this event itself is we want people to take away more awareness of actually what the issue is at hand in Dallas, of all the homeless dogs and these dogs who need help, and we want in the long run, we want to build a community that is going to be surrounded from the Carne Rosa customers and from the Origin customers that will support the shelter that we are hoping to implement in the long run, which is only going to happen if we reach the amount of donations that we truly need, because it is a big project. So things that are going to be at the event is things like food, drink, music, entertainment, which will all be sponsored by Origin and Carne Rosa Restaurant, so great pizza, great fun. And we're going to have multiple booths out there from the Humane Society, from Origin themselves, Carne Rosso Restaurant and Rescue Foundation, PetSmart, other companies like that will come out and support us for this really great cause. In addition to that, we've partnered up with multiple sororities and fraternities from the Dallas local area, so like from SMU and University of Texas at Dallas, that will actually come out to this event themselves because we feel like they have multiple followers that would bring out awareness to the issue. In addition, they will get an opportunity to volunteer and to come out with the event, play with the dogs, to learn new things, and to share that with the people that they know. We've also implemented a plan once the shelter is built that these sororities and fraternities would come out, and other organizations as well, that would come out and actually be able to volunteer monthly with the shelter so that we would have time and a great opportunity for these people to get in that volunteering, but also get a chance to show these dogs that need love, some love and attention. So I'm gonna pass it on to Miss Lava.
Right. The estimated cost to run and to start this facility will be $118,000 annually. After the first year, the first year is a little extra due to fencing because we're gonna have to get fencing, which is $10,000 extra. So the first year will be $128,000. And after that, 118 every year the following, 118,000. We're gonna go ahead and rent land for 4,000 monthly, and our annual budget for that is 48,000. And also we're gonna hire vets and employees. So we're gonna have one vet working 2 days a week, probably 4 hours, around 4 hour shifts. And earning up to $15,000 annually, and then we're gonna hire up to 6 to 7 employees, part-time employees that will be earning $10 an hour, and the annually budget comes out to be for both of them around $70,000. And we can accept volunteers to help around this building.
So to incentivize, this fundraiser that we proudly sponsored, we are happily matching every dollar that we raise at that at the fundraiser with more to match it to show everybody that how important it is to us as the sponsor. Just come on out. It's May 15th between 11 and 2. It's a great time to socialize with other dog owners. It's a great time to socialize with Origin and Carne Rosso. So we appreciate everyone for listening today. And if you have any further questions, you can let us know this time.
One question. So the fundraiser is to decrease awareness for the shelter, not increase adoption.
Well, initially the fundraiser, the big picture at the end of the day is to create a dog shelter for to be able to create a temporary home for these dogs until they are adopted. But the fundraiser is to gain awareness of the situation and to gain money to create that establishment in the future, because it is a hefty amount and it's not pocket change, it's a lot of $30,000. So the fundraiser is essentially to gain capital for the bigger picture, which is the dog shelter.
I actually work at the Carne Rosso in DFLM.
Okay.
And I know, like, me and my fellow employees would actually volunteer. We do volunteer work for the shelter, like, all the time. So for these fundraisers, you wouldn't have to pay us. We would just help volunteer. And the pizzaiola guys and the guys that would make the pizza, they would help out, too. So you could take that out of your costs for employees. Just a suggestion.
Well, the cost for the employees would be towards, like, if and when the shelter is created.
Okay.
To have to people that work constantly, because volunteer is... I can come one day, I may not be able to come another, but having an employee, you're kind of obligated to come at a certain time to keep the flow going.
Right.
And the volunteers are definitely accepted on top of that. So we have a ground base that we would have to pay for them to give us those hours and the time. But the volunteers are accepted to obviously help maximize our goals.
Okay.